Hey, this is John Kevill from Warbringer here. We're happy to announce our new record, Woe to the Vanquished, out March 31st, 2017 on Napalm Records. Here we got the making of the record, some studio footage for you. Check it out.
This is Carlos of Warbringer here at West Valley Studios in Woodland Hills, California, working on our new record with producer Mike Plotnikoff. Everything's been going really well here at the studio so far. Taking the pre-production that we had and bringing it in is making this a lot easier of a process. Everything's been going really smooth. Drum tracks are sounding great. Live drums, as you can see, just doing take after take, trying to nail it. Thanks to all the pre-production we've been doing, it's been a really easy setup to bring that here into the studio, arrange everything. Get out of the shot! See, here we got the drums all set up, mic'd up, it's sounding great. We just put fresh heads on it this morning. Got Remo drum heads, Pearl drums, Vic Firth sticks, all Sabian cymbals. Pretty standard setup, kick, snare, two rack, and a floor. Pearl makes these exclusive rocket toms that I've been using in place of other rotos, etc. They really cut through, especially playing at high tempos, it's awesome. Thanks again for all your continued support. Stay tuned for more updates, my friends. Cheers.
So we're using the whole studio.
Greetings guys, this is Lord Adam Von Carroll from Warbringer, guitar player. I'm currently in week two over here at West Valley Studios. I've done about 9 guitar tracks myself. Mainly relying on my Jackson for rhythms and leads, even using Chase's Legator guitar for some leads. Just get different tones, different playability out of them. So most of my rhythm guitar tracks have been tracked using the Bogner and Wizard. Split them up to where I got some of my leads playing through the orange head and overdubbed with Sound City amp and even some tiny amps. And for this, our 5th studio album, we've got a lot of good stuff coming through. A lot of my personal influences kind of coming back. I'm a huge fan of old school dissection, a lot of Swedish death metal, Entombed and stuff like that. So for me, I get a bit of time to shine a lot of those types of riffs and compositions.
Hey, I'm Chase Becker, new lead guitar player of Warbringer. We're here at West Valley Studios recording the band's 5th album. My main focus on the album has been lead guitar and all my guitar solos. I'm using a Legator, Ninja, 350 Pro, recording through a PV5150 and a Tube Screamer. It's been a great experience so far. The songs are sounding awesome, and I can't wait to hear the end result.
everybody. My name's Jesse Sanchez, and I play bass guitar in Warbringer.
We're at West Valley Studios. It's week two. Continuing bass tracking, guitar tracking, lead guitars. I've been running my bass guitar through an Ampeg head and cab, which is exactly the same that I use live, so it preserves a lot of my live sound. I've been using my Sansap pedal, which is a really cool EQ, kind of a foot switch pedal. I get some really cool crunchy bass tone out of it, a little bit of distortion, some treble. Overall, it sounds nice and bright, nice and tight, just how I like it, you know. And Ibanez guitars. Cool little backstory about this bass is that it was actually used by Fear Factory on a few of their records, as well as live.
Hey, this is John Kevill from Warbringer here, vocals, and we are nearly wrapped up at the studio.
Get on the ground, put your hands where I can see, lying face down!
So the way we did this record, it was written entirely and recorded almost entirely in pre-production beforehand. So everything I'm doing, all the songs I'm singing right now, are take twos of stuff we've already done, and basically the challenge is every single line is going under the microscope and making it have as much character, enunciation, all of that as possible. The studio experience here has been great. As you can kind of see from the videos, we're just in a large house out in Woodland Hills, and it's designed to be a studio from the ground up. So we got a large control room, but it's a really chill setting, a lot of time just sitting outside, which really makes everyone go in feeling really rejuvenated and creative. I've been taking, on average, about 3 hours per song of do it again, do it again, do it again. And honestly, it's been a challenge for my vocal endurance as well as performance to keep that the record-worthy level of delivery on like take 23 of something. Because we are not letting anything that doesn't get an A+ from everyone in the room on the record. And with that being said, it's kind of amazing how quickly it's gone, and it's really just a testament to the skill of the musicians that we have working right now. In addition, the last 2 years, I got my AA in history, and I'm trying to be a history professor in my private life. So some of these kind of themes, which have already been on Warbringer albums since the first one, I've just evolved them, made them more serious, and there's themes about history, but also about where it leads us. As far as the musical content of the record, the side A is absurdly, relentlessly brutal, and the side B opens up a little bit to get to more epic and expansive territory. So it's a really diverse record, but it's also really focused, which I feel is was something we really wanted to change about the last record, is the focus on it, where the whole thing feels like a complete piece. And so we really put a lot into that. Signing off, keep it heavy.
I'm Mike Plotnikoff, and I've been producing records since 1989. Some of the records I've done recently, I just finished producing and mixing the new Inflames record, which will be out November 11th of this year. Also did the new Fear Factory record, which already came out this year, 2016. Also did a Saxon record. It has been great working with Warbringer on their new album. We started 3 weeks ago. We're getting pretty close to the end of the recording of the record. We started with the drums first, tracked all the drums. After the drums were all done, got all the takes edited together, then we did all the guitars, bass, vocals. Oh, it's been a lot of fun actually, because the musicianship's been amazing, and it's been a pleasure, and they take direction really well, and it's just a lot of fun because everybody's so super creative in the band. It's just we spend all the time being creative instead of trying to get the parts right, which makes making the record a lot of fun to do. Normally I track through, like to track everything through the knee, because I like the sound of the Neve. I like the color it gives on everything. I also use a lot of outboard gear, different mic preamps to mix it up a little bit. So I'll use the Neves or the Quad 8s for preamps. Most of it though is run through the Neve. I just find it's, you get the best sounds with it, and everything always sounds good. And I then have a lot of leeway in the mix to do whatever I like. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned for the new Warbringer record in 2017.